So on that note, with the high school level classes and classes in general in eighth grade, we do find that a lot of kids that decide to stay in the high school level classes, even if we ask or request that maybe they should move to pre-algebra or comp science because maybe it's a little above their heads at that level, we find a lot of them, especially in IPS, will find ways of cheating. Unfortunately, what happens with the cheating, you're not using one of the most important IB traits, which of course is being principled. You're also not being a good communicator. Communication is listening as well as talking, so if you're struggling, make sure you let your teachers know the first 9 weeks especially, and hopefully that won't end up with any type of cheating circumstances. But if it does occur, unfortunately, you will get a zero on that test or quiz. And we've had kids in the past writing answers on their pencils, on their legs, Ms. Lesh, their arms, right, Mr. Nestor? You've seen all different types of cheating. And if you're caught with that, the person that is caught will get a zero. So then, of course, like Ms. Holloway said, or Mr. Nestor, and I believe Ms. Lesh and Ms. O'Day, your GPA will therefore plummet because of it. So first 9 weeks is very important to be principled, to be good communicators, and if you feel that you are struggling, please let us know so there will be no indication that you're going to end up cheating in the future and you will use your principalship. Last but not least, probably the most important part, hopefully the funnest part of eighth grade, will be the field trips. End of September, we have a YMCA team building field trip. That's only in eighth grade, sixth and seventh, do not take this field trip. And Ms. Paez and myself, by the way, are both the team leaders. A lot of the other teachers will be assisting with the field trips, but if you have any questions, you can email me or Ms. Paez, who cannot be here tonight. February. I know that date might seem a little strange to some people for a field trip, but at the end of the year in eighth grade, we get so busy with the eighth grade dance, with our eighth grade day, with testing. That's like pretty much the entire last 9 weeks. So the day that sixth and seventh graders go on their field trip, we actually have our eighth grade day and our eighth grade dance usually that same day or at least that week. So our eighth grade trip will be in February. We will probably start selling the tickets, I'm assuming, in December prior to the Christmas break. So it might be a good holiday gift, by the way. We'll also finish up after the holiday break. So just keep in mind that that field trip though can get quite expensive. It's around $120. So keep that in mind. February 8th, the dates have already been booked as long as everything stays in place. We have the buses already solidified, hopefully, but around $120. And we do need to have medical release forms for both of those field trips. So make sure you get that on file as soon as possible at the start of the year. So we're really hoping for a great school year. I recognize a lot of faces. Some of you had Miss, let's see here, Miss Norlin last year, so you probably walked through my class a lot. I'm one of the only teachers in eighth grade who's downstairs. Most of them will be upstairs in the eighth grade wing. I also have an eighth grade daughter who will be with you guys next year, so I'm hoping for a really, really terrific year for all of us. So if you have questions, obviously ask your kids first, teacher second. If it's an eighth grade question, you can go through myself or Ms. Paez, Ms. Holloway, of course, Ms. O'Day, obviously Mr. Jones. But let's hope that the eighth grade students can be responsible enough to take the lead and answer all the questions that you may have ahead of time. And I think that's almost it.